What up, guys? It's the Multitasker. Welcome back again to another reaction. Funny story. I already record of the clip that I did earlier tonight, and I accidentally discarded my reaction of the first one because the plan was that I was going to do two recommendations from Shadow, and I did react to of the clip from WWE's Ruthless Aggression, which that's a new documentary series from WWE Network that brings up the details and the stories about the time the Ruthless Aggression era was a thing since Attitude Era was come to an end. And we are basically going to be watching of a short clip of Randy Orton's journey to Evolution. And at that time of the era, that Randy Orton was definitely the big thing, and that rises from of his career, being as the very first young World Heavyweight Champion, being part of the faction, and which that later that his signature move RKO became such an internet meme. And right now, let's just say that he's becoming as a heel turn in a big way ever since of what he did to Edge. And that's became a little problem, not only that he targeted on Matt Hardy, but also to his Edge's wife, Beth Phoenix, which I didn't see the rest of it at the end of the episode, but I saw the replay and I was like, you gotta be kidding me. And I'm certain this is not the first time Randy would use his trademark onto a female competitor, which I'm pretty sure everybody remembers of the last Royal Rumble that Nia Jax that just entered of the 30-man Royal Rumble, and well, she just got RKO. So, this is my way of trying to make up my little mistake there. So, without further ado, it's time to react.
Faster. Yeah, come in. Yeah. Excuse me, who the hell are you interrupting me? That's right. You're Randy Orton.
And from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 240 pounds, Randy Orton!
Well, this is Randy Orton's debut. I'm going to wish the kid luck.
I came out, my arm in a sling, to inform the world that I was going to be okay. Supposed to be a babyface type feel type moment. And that Montreal crowd all over me, and it was great.
Wait a minute.
I promise.
This is disrespectful of these Canadians.
I promise to write back and respond to everybody.
I think I remember seeing that one
right
time.
I was like, oh, we got something here.
Yeah, we got breaking news.
Ah! Oh, God.
Hi, Randy Orton here with another special injury update. I have great news to announce.
And we didn't want to have to reintroduce Randy to the audience. Got a bump in the road, but it's not a stop.
I'm Randy Orton, and I'm here to let everyone know that I recently suffered a setback in my rehabilitation. My shoulder sling has been chafing me, leaving a portion of my skin irritated and susceptible to infection. But luckily, doctors caught it early, applied some antibacterial ointment, and the skin healed.
We came up with this idea of having some ridiculous random number attributed to how much he's recovered.
My shoulder now has 32% mobility. That's up 2% from last week.
You know, the way Randy would deliver that line with this smirky confidence, you know, just kind of made you get him a little bit.
I've got to say that this setback really got me down.
Oh, I look back, they were cheesy and horrible, but like some of the best stuff.
Yeah, I'll say it was cheesy for you, man.
Because with your support, I know I'll be back in no time.
Randy Orton's shoulder was finally 100% healed. He quickly reestablished himself as one of WWE's top prospects. But Orton could not have imagined what lie ahead as Triple H's idea of faction began to materialize.
And it was very clear, Randy Orton.
Boy, you talk about a blue chipper. A young man that's got a magnificent future. He was bred to be a WWE superstar.
Randy had every tool in the world. Looks and every tool imaginable to be the success in his business.
Look at this, look at this! It's coming! Orton knocks the champion down!
People often talk about the it factor. Nobody can really define the it.
Yes, we have arrived.
But Randy had that characteristic that just when you walked in a room, you knew that he was going to be a star someday.
This kid has got a great future. He's got wonderful potential.
He reminded me of myself when I was 23 and like I was up until about 5 years ago.
I never asked why me, like why did Hunter or Rick see me as being a part of Evolution? It's just common sense would tell me that they saw something in me.
We may be looking at the future of Raw right there.
One night, it went horribly bad. Everything we'd been working on, they'd forgot. And I said, Dave, you have to forget everything that everybody taught you up until this point. We're going to reboot you from ground one. And Randy, this stuff is easy for you, but if I see you out there not taking this seriously like that again, we're done. I remember having the title at the time because I came in the locker room and I threw it, made a huge racket, and I said, that is the last f***ing time that'll ever happen.
Whoa.
You guys got to get your f***ing together. We start over as of this moment, or we're done, because I'm not going to have that happen again.
It was nice. In the ring with Bubba and I. And we went to go lift him up, and as we lift him up, I remember coming down nice and smooth.
The move was double flapjack. I have a leg. Devon has a leg. Somehow, Randy Orton's other leg got underneath my back as I was falling.
So when Bubba landed, he landed on Randy's ankle.
Ow.
So that shattered his ankle.
The way I look at it, the three of us in that moment in time made a mistake.
So then somebody comes running in the room, goes, oh my God, Randy Orton just got hurt. And as I'm running down the hallway to see what's happening, here comes Dave. And Dave is like pissed and holding his arm and he's yelling. He's like, I tore my tricep, and I'm like, oh, wait, it was you. Like, they told me it was Randy, and it was his foot, and it's your arm, and it's Dave. And he's like, no, Randy's in the ring. He broke his foot.
Just 1 month after Evolution's debut, Triple H's goal of elevating two young stars seemed destined for failure. Triple H and Ric Flair were left to fend for themselves. But a surprise return gave the group a glimmer of hope.
Who's that guy?
I don't know. I have X-ray vision.
It's Randy Orton.
He's back.
Orton's return created a sense of urgency in Batista.
I was so anxious to get back. I wanted to get back as fast as possible.
To keep pace, Evolution would consider evolving without Batista.
I started hearing rumors that they might replace me and that they were looking at Mark Jindrak.
So when I heard about this Evolution thing where I was going to be part of it with Randy Orton, who we off camera were boys, to be in a group with Ric Flair and Triple H, I mean, that was crazy. That was amazing.
The fact that me and him were tight and we rode together and always were having a good time on the road, and Hunter and Rick knew that they wanted, and he was a hell of an athlete too, more athletic than me. He had like a 50-inch vertical, like he could do some really crazy shit with his athletic ability.
Being in the car with a third grader, I'm not kidding. At one point in time, they had one of those wheels that you push the button and it makes animal noises. Like the thing spins around and whatever animal it lands on, it'd make the noise. And the two of them are in the back of the car making animal noises.
Oh, T. T is for Tasmanian devil.
Because Orton and I were always goofing around and stuff. Maybe I was him and I were bad together. Like a bad, us together was immaturity and I don't know.
When I put Randy in the car with just us, because Jindrak wasn't on one of the tours, I'm like, he's great. When he's not with the other guy, when he's with Jindrak, I'm gonna throw them both off a bridge. So I told Rick, I was like, never put the two of those two together in the car with us again. I mean, ever, and I don't want to ever be in a car with Jindrak again. Then you answer them.
It got all the way to the point where they had him wear a black suit, and we did like the Reservoir Dogs, like walk down the street with the heat coming off the pavement.
I see that picture of us walking over the horizon. It was Flair, Orton, myself, and Triple H.
We filmed a bunch of stuff with Mark with the intention that he was going to be in Evolution. But we also filmed stuff without Mark.
Whoa. I didn't know about that.
I remember thinking, like, oh, man.
Oh,
like,
shit.
Is he seeing what's happening here? Like, they're doing this because they're not sure yet. It was tough because we were close. He was my best friend at that point in my career. Spent a lot of time together. And to see him upset about that, and anybody would be upset, that's a thing to have to go through.
Triple H, I think, was the final guy who said, he's out. I can honestly say he was right. Whoever made the decision to take me out of it was correct in doing so.
But it was Triple H, pretty obvious.
Randy Orton, no one questioned whether or not he would be the future. The only question was, how long is it going to take before he just takes over from everybody? Randy was ready to rule the world.
Oh my God! Oh my God! He's done it! Randy Orton has done it! Destiny Jr., the youngest world champion in history!
The youngest,
in less than
the first
2 years,
youngest,
empowered by Evolution, Randy Orton turned all that
ever.
Unrealized potential into reality.
I remember getting the call because I was in a vitamin shop at the time in Union Square, and like me being in a vitamin shop is more natural than Randy being a babyface champion. The fans were not clamoring for Randy to become a babyface champion to them, and it was an unnatural position for Randy to be.
In other words,
they
were not ready,
playing this
ready
cocky
for
prick
for him to be the kind of type of a champion that they
much.
Want to see him.
I'm a babyface. I'm a babyface. Smile, you little punk.
Looking for attractive people. Slim Pickens.
Sometimes a guy is a natural babyface. Randy's on the other side of the fence. He's like, I don't want to be around you people. You piss me off. Get away from me.
I'm the new big man in town.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, go tell your friends.
Okay.
Seriously, go.
You can rush.
Seriously, go. At 24, I became the youngest world heavyweight champion, and I don't think I was ready. I was young, and I didn't know what it was to be champion. You know, it got thrust upon me, and I had a lot of learning on the job.
He became a monster. And not everybody does, but he did.
Yeah, I'm loved extremely, actually. I found that out last night in the hotel lobby.
Randy is a glorious prick. I mean, he is just an outstanding son of a bitch.
I'm here in Orlando for a commercial for the Royal Rumble. Honestly, my reaction at first was that I didn't want to do it. But then I got here and I got to, you know, the studio, looked around, and still didn't want to do it.
We had a long talk, and I said, Randy, you have every gift imaginable to be the biggest star this business has ever seen. And the only one that can stop you is you. And you are hell-bent on doing it, and I don't know why.
But first,
The Undertaker, the legend.
I remember this match. This is from WrestleMania 21.
WrestleMania.
Believe it or not, this was my very first pay-per-view that I get to watch this with. Back then, I had to watch through the fucking static.
I've been given so many opportunities because of my stint in Evolution, because of the right people saw that there was something special about Randy Orton.
Norton says he is a one-man dynasty. There's not a man, woman, or child on earth that can deny that.
You don't have what it takes, then Evolution will leave you behind. So if you wake up one day and you're wondering what in the hell happened, Evolution has just passed you by.
But of course, his path went from Evolution to Legend Killer to Apex Predator, and still in his prime. Now, the question is, what's going to happen next week? Because the road to WrestleMania is definitely around that corner. So, I don't know what's going to happen, but I personally hope that Edge will make a surprise to everyone, because it may not happen, but I would like to see RKO versus Rated R just one more match, just to see this. It's probably gonna be a no holds barred or an unsanctioned match, because it's not gonna be pretty. I can guarantee that. Because, yeah, it's personal. No offense, man. No offense, Randy, but you are losing the crowd there. But that's all I got to say. So, thank you, Shadow. And time's up. This is where I'm going to end this video. So, if you enjoyed this, all you have to do is just drop it likes and leave a comment down below. And maybe this is just out of the limp. But I'm wondering if there's any of any of the highlight moments of Asuka. Just asking. So if you let me know, you know, hook a brother up. But that's all I got to say. But I'll catch you in the next video. So take care. Mighty signing out.